He said, I want my whole life, every relationship I had, it affected. I blamed myself. I felt unworthy. He said, it wasn't until I was in my 20s. He said, I sent a message to my dad and told him that I forgive him and I wanted to have a relationship with him. He said he wanted one, but he's fallen through. He said, but the thing that it helped was I forgave him, but it set me free. It changed my marriage. It changed the relationship with my children. You see, Jacob, it's time to let go. It feels comfortable. It feels right. But my. Until you learn to get out of Laban's house, you are never, ever, ever going to be who God wants you to be and experience the blessings of God. Sister Holly, if you come this morning, I don't know who I'm preaching to. Maybe I'm preaching to one. Maybe I'm preaching to everyone. I can tell you this morning that I'm preaching by reflecting on my life in a lot of ways. I look for those times to leave things. And as I did, I can see how God's hand moved and blessed. Who's ready to be a billionaire? Jesus Christ. Because every one of you in here can be. But Jacob, you gotta get rid of Laban. I don't know what goes on in Laban's house. I don't know what he must have felt, but the season was over. God has a plan for Laban, but God certainly had a plan for Jacob, for Leah, and for those sons. 12 being the 12 tribes of Israel. One being the leader of the priesthood. God had a plan. But if Jacob would have never stepped out, would the plan for his seed ever have been what it needed to be? Listen, if there's envy and jealousy in your heart because of things in your family, I don't even know the details of your family. I don't even know the nitty gritty. I don't even know the dirt. I don't want to. But God does. And if there's envy, you better get taken care of before it comes jealousy. Because jealousy is as cruel as the grave, the Bible says. If you look around the sanctuary and your heart is jealous of someone else in the kingdom of God, you better get it taken care of. If you can't rejoice with someone else when God blesses them, whether it's with a spiritual blessing, whether it's with growth of their family, whether it's with a new house or a new car, amen. You know what? We need to learn to rejoice with one another. And if we can't, there's a problem. We need to get it solved. So it allows us the liberty to move on to greater things. I love in the book of Deuteronomy, in Deuteronomy chapter number 2, verse number 2, and I'm closing with this. The Bible says, and the Lord spake unto me, saying, you have compassed this mountain long enough. Turn ye northward. 38 years is long enough to wander around the mountain. It's time to go northward. It's time to take the mountain. It's time to go where the promises of God are, where milk and honey are flowing, and where God allows you to conquer giants and experience great things. But you've got to be the one to get out of the rut. It's easy to build a rut. We went to a farm, a pumpkin farm. We took the girls there when we were in Ohio. And while we were there, Brother Dennis, they were taking John Deere tractor rides in these little cars. Just a little area. They've only been doing it for days. But you know what? You know exactly where the tractors were. Go up the steering wheel by Bobby and let the tractor go, because it was a big rut. It's time some of us get out of the rut and begin to take the mountain God has for us. If we ever want destiny and purpose and understand who we are in Christ, we're going to have to get out of the rut and allow God's blessing to be. that's you, would you gather in this morning and say, God, here I am.